My hours are slumberless. Dearest, the shadows I live with are numberless. Little white flowers will never awaken you. Not where the black coach of sorrow has taken you. Darling, I hope that my dream never haunted you. My heart is telling you how much I wanted you. Gloomy Sunday. You
know how every Sunday there's like something going on with like TV? Everybody's always watching the Emmy winning shows. You know, you watch with your friends and your family and your family. I usually watch TV alone. You know, everyone talks about that show House of Cards. I don't actually have anything to say about that. I always thought it would be sweet having a brother or sister to watch Speed Racer with, you know. Got kind of lonely, pretending I was Butch Cassidy just waiting for Sundance to show up at playtime. Crazy stuff I would have got into if I had a brother. I mean, some crazy stuff. So what's up with Twitter? Find your long lost family.com. Name, Barry Harris, age 28, mother's name. Maiden name. Okay.
You have one undiscovered long lost relative.
You gonna drink coffee or something?
No. Thanks. I don't think so. No.
Well, what'd you want to meet here in the first place then if you ain't gonna eat or drink nothing?
Well, you suggested that we meet here.
Well, shit.
So, Rollo. What kind of name is that?
It's Rollo. I don't know.
Sorry. Rollo. It's an interesting name.
My ma, well, our ma, thought it'd be nice to name me after a nobleman of a Norwegian descendant. It's like the founder of the fucking Viking principality.
Oh, that's right. Duke of Normandy.
I don't know what that fucking means. Like a goddamn encyclopedia or something?
No. No. But you're half Jewish. It just seems somewhat peculiar of Ma, doesn't it?
God bless her. No judgment.
Man, I barely knew Ma.
Yeah, I know, it's a damn shame. I just can't believe we're meeting for the first time like this. I mean, this is fucking crazy. You know, it should be like a reality show or something, you know? What the hell are the cameras at? In all seriousness, and I'm not saying this out of anger, nothing like that. You know, no judgment. But I think, well, I think she was kind of a whore.
What? You mean Ma?
Yeah, but I ain't saying that out of hate or nothing like that. But think about it for a second. She had me with my father, right?
Yeah.
Then she left after like a year or two. Then she had you with your father.
Yeah. I mean, she left when I was like 10. But it's not like she like left. Sorry.
Nice.
You know, she did have a boyfriend, though. I mean, so I didn't see her much.
See, that's what I'm saying. She had a boyfriend. She probably ended things with him and had another one. She probably had more fucking kids, too.
But you're implying that she's a hooker?
Wait, whoa. No. It's not like that. Nothing like that. I didn't say that. What the fuck's the matter with you, Roy? No, I'm just saying, you know, if you're a woman and you're fooling around a lot, you brace yourself for a fucking title. But I ain't saying she's a hooker. No, Christ's sake, and I ain't talking about her out of hate, even though I didn't know her. I mean, bless her, she gave me life.
Giving life is nice. It's funny, she never mentioned you, huh?
No judgment.
So, you're a businessman?
Shit, how'd you come to that conclusion?
You know, the way you dress and the way you talk and move your hands, it's a distinctive characteristic of a businessman.
Well, I guess you could say I'm a businessman. What about you?
I'm a comedian.
You're a comedian? Holy shit, seriously? Well, you gotta tell me a joke. Tell me a joke. I need a joke. Come on.
No.
Come on, fine. Seinfeld. Fucking lay one on me. Let me hear something. What do you got?
All right. I'll tell you one. All right, so... I was looking through my Twitter, and I see this couple tweeting at each other, like... And they're always publicly sharing how much they love each other. Oh, baby, I love you, baby. And like, oh, baby, I love you so much, baby. Oh. How about you get a little more interesting, right? How about you start tweeting sex, like phone sex, but like tweet sex? Show us how much you really love each other, right? Like, oh, baby, I'm so glad we tried anal last night, baby. Oh, yeah, right. At least then, you know, at least we know you're being... fully honest, right?
What? That was the fucking joke?
Yeah. You know, Twitter, the social site? You don't have Twitter?
Nah, I don't know that social shit. I don't do that. I fuck girls. I don't know, Roy. I didn't think it was funny, to be honest with you.
Oh. Yeah, you know, I don't have Twitter. I just know about it and all, and I just thought Making a joke out of something that everybody in the world uses might be funny.
Yeah, work on it. I didn't think it was funny. Just saying. So this is your favorite spot in Brooklyn, huh? I like it.
Yeah, I'd come here and write some jokes. I don't know, I guess you could say it's relaxing. There's always people here, too. I mean, you're never really secluded. So there's friends and families and couples. While you're hanging out, you listen to them talk and talk, and then you'll catch some small piece of honesty. And it makes a stale and ordinary day. It makes it somewhat considerate.
Not every day is going to be something, so I guess I know what you're talking about.
I know I'm not that good of a comedian. Just gives me some way to express myself, I assume.
I know you're not that fucking funny. I'm just busting your balls. Half-brother's got to start fresh sometime. Exchange some jokes. It's all right, you know? Think about it. This ain't one of them stale days. This is good. I like it.
Can't believe I'm hanging out with my discovered half-brother.
Fucking crazy, you found me. I mean, who the fuck would think we're related? I'm related to Carrot Top. Eh?
Come on. It's funny. It's funny. Sorry about that. I had to make sure my bathroom ceiling wasn't leaking again.
Your bathroom ceiling? Was it leaking?
A few drips.
Well, Roy, shouldn't you get that checked up by a plumber? It could be something serious, you know, for Christ's sake.
No, it's fine, really. I mean, few drips here and there. You know, I got a bucket, so it's all right.
You should get that fixed, right? I can make a few calls, get that fixed. I know a few good people good at that. Are these jokes?
Yeah, I've been working on them. Oh, geez, Rollo, where are my manners, huh? Are you hungry? Do you want something to eat?
Yeah, sure, thanks, Roy.
I hope you like rice pudding. It's good.
You like that, huh? It's good.
It's good, it's good.
You've lived here long enough?
Whole life. Used to live here with Mom. So, where are you from originally? Brooklyn?
No, Astoria, Queens. My pa moved me downtown when I was 16. Hey, can I ask you something?
Sure.
What made you want to meet me? Now.
Curious? I mean, I'm just curious to know if I wasn't the only one of whatever's left of my family, you know. Just curious to see if, you know, there's any blood, any relations, you know, out and about. Just being curious. I tend to be curious. I'm curious.
I gotta tell you, I was definitely a little out of it before meeting you. You never really know who you're dealing with, you know. I've always had this issue with trust. Just because it's something I take a pride on, you know? People I've dealt with just all kind of just come around for a certain thing, you know? But it's never for, the talky talk. And, you know, getting to, you know, I guess, whatever this is, I guess, you know? Don't mind me saying this, you're an interesting guy. You're different, Roy. It's pretty good.
So you're a businessman, hmm? I mean, I made that conjecture earlier and it seemed to be precise.
No, yeah, why? Was that like a problem or something?
No. I think it's great. I mean, you make a lot of money. And I mean, I've been thinking this. Okay, bear with me on this. I'm not doing too good with money right now. And you seem to be a man of capital. I mean, considering your appearance of flashy true treasures.
Oh, whoa. Wait, what?
I mean, you're a prosperous guy. I mean, you're in good hands of money. I mean, just look at your appearance. I mean, it's really something.
Roy, are you asking me about money? I don't believe this. Sitting here in your fucking shit smell apartment, eating. What the fuck is this? You serious? Pudding? Is it fucking pudding? Are you a goddamn grandmother?
You said it was pretty good.
And you have the nerve to ask me about my fucking profession as a moneymaker? Are you serious?
I was trying to make a compliment. I mean, I was getting to a point.
A point? Okay, I get it. It makes sense. Okay. Nice setup.
Wait, what? What?
It's a nice show you put up, your fucking degenerate.
Wait, you got it all wrong.
You know, you got a real way of words, Roy fucking Harris.
Wait, we're brothers! I'm sorry, half-brothers.
You wanna know something? I've dealt with motherfuckers trying to take money I've earned. You put a nice little fucking family scenario in the middle of this, you're not gonna fool me. That's why you're so fucking anxious to hit me, you son of a bitch. I should fucking kill you. What's the matter with you? Huh? You think you fuck with me? You think you fuck with me? You think you fuck with me?
Stop it! All right. I'm broke, right? This apartment, they're gonna kick me out soon. I'm alone. I can't make good money. Fucking loser. It's not how I wanted it to happen. Please.
I shouldn't have brought up that stuff about the money. I'm sorry. I was stupid. It was a stupid thing to say. I'm stupid. I say stupid things, all right? I just don't know. I don't know how to talk like you. I want to try, but I can't. I don't know how to do it. I just wanted this to go well. Something about you. Something in your beard. It reminds me of Mom. Not me.
You're really fucking stupid, you know that? You need to learn to watch your fucking mouth. Fucking run your mouth like that. You can't just fucking say shit. Huh? You just can't say whatever the fuck comes to your mind. You gotta think a little bit. You know, there's a park down the street. My pa used to take me there. Why don't you come with me?
Huh?
Yeah? Mm. Alright, come on.
Here is the shadows. I live with the numberless. Little white flowers will never awaken you. Not where the black coach of sorrow has taken you. Angels have no thought.
That is where I got my first blowjob.
Really?
Yeah, but it was freezing out. It was like she was sucking a popsicle.
Your dick was a popsicle.
Gloomy Sunday.